Welcome to today's class. My name is Mr. Nathaniel, and the topic for today's class is retro fashion style. You can read more about the retro fashion style in our textbook, and I will be taking you through a different type of retro fashion style. Now, I'll be taking you on retro fashion style, and you can actually read more about this fashion style. The first thing I will do is to start with the neck. When it comes to the retro look, now this is the neck. I have the neck, I have the placket, which is the button stand. Yeah, I have my button because I'm using my croquis book. Now it's more of a sleeveless top. But the first thing I'll do, I'll go around the neck, close to the neck, towards the chest area, take my hands this way, drawing this square close to the neck for the flounce. Now pick the flounce on each side. I raise the flounce from the shoulder because it's a sleeveless top. I don't need to see the shoulder. So this is a square. I took the stroke. Sometimes the strokes can guide you. These three strokes can actually guide you through the flounce. Now this is the flounce all the way down to the waist, and it's more of an high-waisted trouser. Slightly fitted towards the knee, not too fitted. Because this is retro, it's a retro. Now this is gathered at this point. It's gathered. Now this is to illustrate the gathered effect. Now this is, you can see this is the retro look I'm talking about. Now for the next look. Which is still retro. Is the off-shoulder dress, off-shoulder top, three-quarter sleeve, it's fitted. And it has a flare skirt. Now that's the second look. It's an off shoulder top, three quarter sleeve with a flare skirt. This is another retro look. Now I'll be looking at one more retro look. There's the collar, this is a collar dress. Long sleeve. Tied waist. towards the side, you can see the tie. A little bit loose at the waist, but the belt helps to give that fitting. The belt gives the fitting, which is a tight waist. The same zigzag effect towards the nail area with gathered towards the nail. There's a cut towards the nail and with a gathered design, gathered flounce. Now I'm done with my retro look. The next thing I want to do is to try and color the skin. Where you have the skin, I always talk about the skin. Always shade your skin properly where you know it's skin. You show, okay, this is skin area. The face. The neck. Because this is, you can see the skin, because this is an off shoulder, the face, the hand, where I have the leg. This, I only just have the face. I always trace with the darker shade to trace around the skin to give. I always talk about the body tone, like giving the body a shadow. So this is your line art. I'm going towards the side of the body using the dark shade, dark brown, to trace the body, to give shadow to the body. Makes it look unique and different, beautiful. The hair, I'm using that shade of brown. Always make sure you trace properly or you shade properly. Make sure your work is neat. Try not to run, take your colors out of the line art. I always say that, always do a neat job. Makes your work beautiful when you shade properly. I'm leaving a little bit patch, little white patches towards the midpoint of the mid area of the hair to show that light, that I'm not shading all, leaving a little bit of white at some area, particular area. It makes the hair look nice and it makes it look real. Take the right colors I need for the pants. Always emphasizing that, always trace out your work. Be careful not to run out of the lines. Shade properly. Sometimes I trace out my line at with the right color I'm using for the dress, so I don't make mistake. I stay inside the line art, make sure I don't run my colors out of my line art, so my work looks neat and looks beautiful. done with this one. I'm moving to the next. First, I traced out my liners. That's the first thing I'm doing. When you're painting your shoe, always be careful when you are doing that. Make sure you don't mess up your work. Try and do a neat job. Trace properly. I always talk about tracing out your line art. You can use felt pen to trace. At the same time, I talked about you using your fine liner pen if you have it. Try not to mess up your work. Do not put much pressure. I don't put much pressure on the pen when I'm using it to trace out my line art. I just try to be careful when I'm doing that. If you don't trace out your line art, the beauty of your work, you can't see the beauty of your work. Just give beauty to your work. And good finishing, it's important when you are doing this. So your work looks beautiful, at the same time it looks presentable. the polka dot fabric. My retro, I want to give it a touch of polka dots. You can as well have different colors of it. Now here we come to conclusion of the retro fashion style, and it's more of polka dots. Now you have polka dots in different shades and different colors. You can make yours colorful as well. Don't forget to always trace your work properly and knit. Make sure your work is neat.